townhouse. Okay, cool. Hello. You see a man of around 30 years of age. He is playing nervously with a kitchen knife. He has a thick bandage around his head and looks at you grimly and mistrustfully. Norlael, 27 years old. What do you want here? Go away. You can see that I am in a bad mood. Really? Hello? Anthony! No. Bandits? Anything about that madman? No. Anything about New Lake? Do you know Sabine? Or Sandra? Or the Thieves Guild? Bad mood? Never mind. There's nothing we can talk to him about. No offense. We are already leaving. Who's we? Leaving. Guy's in a bad mood. I have no idea. I wish I could take some of these as torches. That would be great. But no. He's following me. Oops. Oh, there's someone else here. Okay, then that's the one I talked to. Then who's this? We look like triplets here. You see a young woman. She is wearing a long kitchen apron and waves a large potato peeler at you in a threatening gesture. Oh, we're gonna come to blows? Bring it on, old lady. She's not that old. Canth, 26 years old. Oh, I am sorry. I hope I did not frighten you. In fact, I was frightened myself when I saw you. Since the wine goblets were stolen, I have been rather nervous. Wine goblets. A few weeks ago, they stole one of our golden wine goblets. I heard a noise at night in the dining room and got up. As I opened the door to the dining room, I just saw a green figure with long wings flying off through an open window. Yes, yes, it was flying. I did not want to believe my eyes, but that was what I saw. The next morning, I found that one of the wine goblets was missing. I must tell you, we have had them since our wedding, and were very attached to them. A few days later, the second one was also stolen. This time, my husband heard the thief. He got up quietly and was able to challenge him, but unfortunately, there were two of them. The other one attacked my husband from behind and bruised him badly. My husband now naturally believes that the first wine goblet must also have been stolen by these bandits. He says they were disturbed on the first occasion when I came downstairs and simply came back a few days later. He believes the green figure I saw was simply a woman's imagination at play, but whatever my beloved husband says, I am quite certain that it was a winged being that stole the first wine goblet. It's fairies. Someone else has had a problem with those fairies. The House of the Baron. No, can't say anything about the fairies. She called them figures. You know, Anthony? Nothing about hello. You going on a journey? You leaving? Do you know Sabine? Or Sandra? You think it might be the Thieves Guild? wine. You know that madman in prison, no? Let's see if we can pick anything out of here. Green figure. Long wings. Wedding. Bandits. See, I did ask her about bandits, didn't I? No. Green figure, maybe ask. A wedding. I doubt the wedding's of any importance. Oh, alright. Green figure. Nope, okay. Farewell, and watch out for the bandits. I will. Look at all these barrels. Nothing in them. So it's like town hall, but these are not town hall type places. These are just people's homes. Alright, we've finally been there. Now we can check out down that way. We also have down this way. I can just fast travel back over there. And other than down here, yeah, I do want to check out the wharf. Not the cemetery yet. Getting dark. Pretty sure that's where we want to go. Right. So I'm 11 now. You have hardly entered the alley when several dark figures appear from the shadows around the houses. One of the bandits is playing with a long knife and seems rather bored. Your money or your life. Without warning for your decision, without waiting for your decision, the mob attacks you. So much for telling me that. Hi. Three of them. Bandit, bandit, bandit. Alright. Added 2 points. Nice, right away. How was that one attacking me? 3 more points. Oh, he's just Okay, he's just like straightening his outfit and everything. One point on me. I want to take one of them out. Now I got three on me. Damn it. That's what they do, see that? And he moves back. I'm switching back to him because I damaged him already, so I wanna... Hopefully one hit will take him out. I only did three damage, I think, on him, though. But a good five damage might do him in. Oh, four did it. Four damage, nice. Another one on me. Guys are treating, well. Bandit's leather was broken, and then I killed him. That's the bandit's leather, right? Not mine? And mine's fine. Oh, right, I forgot about that amulet. I want to try putting that on. Can be dangerous, though. I don't know what it does. 3 points. No, come back. Back here. Alright. Broken leather. Nice. Level 5. 33 hit points total. Power points, 35. Spell learning points, 23. Training points, now 24. Nice. I approve. I don't approve not being able to pick up all the gold. I'm gonna drop another 10 rations. Oops, that goes quickly. I mean, I may be wasting money because I don't know how many gold equals rations. But I'm not sure if I can sell rations back? Maybe. I guess I'll take those too. Wait, can I take this? Now? No. Still can't take. I'll take these. Still want to sell this stuff. Oops. I want to save over that. There we go. Oh, what's that saying? The sign shimmers in a strange blue light, and the words say, "Karsten was here." Yeah, he's the one of the. Or the creator of the Amber series. Karsten Copper, I believe. Alright, so where are we now? We've explored a lot of this area. Let's skip to the merchant. Is he always open? The door is locked. It almost seems as if the shop is closed at the moment. It would seem that way because it is that way. I would go back and rest, but I want to go see what's down to the south, which would be left. Oh! Drawing knives and stuff. So many bandits. 1 point of damage on me. I did 4, nice. This guy's not just letting his friend do all the fighting. Another 4. One more hit will do it. 5. Bye bye. Just you and me, buddy boy. Damage. I need a 2 on me. He's retreating. He's back. Let's slice him up. Oh, damn it. This guy's all over the place. 4 damage. He's leaving for good now because I damaged him again. ninety XP. Can't pick that up. I haven't been to this area. I don't know what this building is. It's definitely something. Maybe another merchant, I hope? Tolimar's horses. Nope. Open from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. You'll be able to return to this point later. The healer charges very little. Oh, I love this. I love it. It's not here. I know I could go to the other place and sleep in the cellar, but I might be attacked by spiders. Except I think I cleared them all out. But I'm here, and it's only 5 gold. This will bring me up to my new maximum. But what happened? Did I not actually? I didn't actually sleep. What happened? I must have said no or something. Yes. I didn't select this. 15, nice. 33 life points now. Level 5 adventurer. Oh, the House of Healers, right. I'm looking for Father Anthony. He's gone to help someone who is dying to ease their passage into Bela's realm. He doesn't even say when he'll be back or where I can find this guy right now if I wanted to. There's no option. Maybe someone else can help or has some information about Anthony. Because the boy doesn't know much, apparently. Hello. I think that's just the farmer's wife. Or it might be what's her... Yeah, it is the farmer's wife. Excuse me. I'm looking for... What's her name? Oh, Sandra! I didn't meet her before. Awesome. Welcome to the House of Healers. My name is Sandra, and I am the head of the healers here in Spannenberg. Welcome especially to you, Citrine. I remember your grandfather... grandmother well. A long, long time ago, she once helped me by saving my cat from the monsters. Oh, that her name was Sandra? I guess so. The little girl who was running around in Twin Lake. They saved her from... Saved the cat. I forget the cat's name. Yeah, save the cat from the sewers was gonna be basically killed in a ritual by the king of the rats. The rat king. Tell me, have you perhaps heard anything about my daughter, Sabine? Alright, so I can ask about... I can bring up grandfather... Spannenberg, maybe. I haven't asked anything about Spannenberg. Grandfather Spannenberg, Cat, and Sabine. Tomcat. If you can tell me the name of my old Tomcat, I will give you something wonderful. Well, do you know his name? Felix. Felix the Cat. Ah, you heard the story, didn't you? Well, yes, he... has been dead for a long time, but in the years we were together, he made my childhood very happy. Of course, if you guys haven't really realized, already realized, this is harkening back to the events of Ambermoon, in the beginning of Ambermoon. I would like to give you a present in remembrance of Felix. With these words, old Sandra touches each of you, there's only one, unfortunately, on the forehead and says, now you can understand the language of the animals. Use this gift only to benefit the animals, otherwise it will turn you inside out. My god, what the hell? She's gonna turn me inside out. She's insane. Maybe we can come back with more party members and she will grant it to the rest of them as well. Because she said the same thing again. Sabine. She's a healer, just like me, and leads the House of Healers in Burnville on the island to the south of us. Unfortunately, I've heard nothing more from her for weeks, and that is why I'm very worried that something has happened. It would be nice of you if you could check in on my daughter in Burnville. I will give you this key. It fits the chest in my room. In the chest, you will find a few things which could be useful to you on your journey. You will also find a key in the chest. You can use it to open the shortcut to Burnville. If you go from the quay southwards to the next island... I can't even pick up this stuff yet. I need to sell things or, like, store some stuff in the house. Grandfather's house. I can add this to the Sandra entry if I have any. I don't have much room. Sabine. continued. Key opens shortcut to Burnville. I wonder if we're going in there soonish. Go from Quay southwards. Southwards to next island. Sorry guys, just gotta write this down. There's no journal in Ambermoon or Amberstar. To the next island, you will reach the tunnel. Alright, to get to tunnel. I guess the key goes there and you get into the tunnel that way. Alright. Sandra's key. Well, we definitely could pick this up. Are you kidding? I can't pick up the key. Give me the thing. I'm so used to selecting something here to pick something up. Sabine is my daughter. She is a healer in Burnville. This time daughter has a different... Oh, Burnville. We can ask about Burnville. Daughter has a different explanation or reaction. Burnville is a small town in the middle of the desert on an island to the south of here. The people living there are mainly artists and tradesmen. South. Did I write that there? Yeah, island to south in middle of the desert. Right. You know what Anthony is? No. Anything about an antidote? Nope. Anything about bandits? About that cellar? No. Well, she doesn't want anybody. What about the madman? Are you kidding me? The madman. You don't want anybody bothering or letting him out. New Lake. You know anything about fairies? No. Ask you about your own self? You don't know anything about yourself. Thieves Guild? I'm at the park now. Alright. Tunnel. Key. I don't even want to open that chest yet because I can't take anything out of it. She does not want to join my party. Go in peace, my children, and may Gala protect you on your travels. Gotta say, you have some excellent music playing in here. I really approve. This might be Clementine. She could stop hiding behind me. Where'd she go? Oh. Anthony. No. Antidote. We gotta find this guy. So we can heal that poor girl. Give the antidote to us. Or to him. The fisherman. And who's... this person? Well, let's zip back over here. The horse. I'm not gonna get one. I just want to see what the guy has to say. Oh, we can actually walk around in here and stuff. Oh, we were supposed to meet Tolimar. And a new song. Freaking love it. Horse dealer has pickaxe and tools for the chest. Alright. Well, before we do that, let me take a look at his barrels. Sometimes barrels have torches and other things in them. Right. Are you Tolimar? You see a giant of man. A giant of a man. He has muscular, hairy arms and grins at you with a broad smile. Tolimar, age 49. Welcome to Tolimar's horse stables. You will only find the best horses here. What can I do for you? Horses. This song is weird. Yes, come with me to the stables. I have 6 very fast horses there. I think you will like them. If so, please pay for them in the office at the end of the stables. I'm not getting one yet. Just asking about it. You know where this guy Anthony might be, no? Anything about an antidote, no? Anything about bandits? Or Burnville? Hello. No. No one says hello anymore. You know anything about this madman, no? Or New Lake? You know Sabine? Or Sandra? Do you know the Thieves Guild? You have tools. So you need tools? Well, I am not an ironmonger, but perhaps we can do business. A few days ago, Silverhand and his bandits robbed my business here. The main thing I am sorry about is that they took my 4 golden horseshoes. If you can return all 4 of them to me, I will be pleased to give you some tools. Oh boy. I was hoping we could trade. Silverhand. Alright. So Tolimar. Yeah, return horseshoes. I'm just gonna add that to Tolimar's little entry. That's my first quest. Return. They're golden horseshoes. Golden horseshoes from... I guess this might be the horse theme? That's supposed to be a horse name? you wouldn't say anything about bandits, what about Silverhand then? No. Horseshoes. It did have him listed as 2 separate words, but let me try... one word, horseshoes, no. Alright. I hope I can be of service to you. You know what? I doubt it. Thank you. Welcome, I see you in need of some fine horses. Not just yet, buddy boy. Because that's it for this area. I'm actually surprised we could even walk in here. Well, it's good that we visited Tolimar. I'm not ready for that cemetery. How about the wharf? I know it's right there. As you open the door to the office at the boatyard, a young boy comes toward you. He says, I am very sorry, but unfortunately Captain Torl is not here. Oh, yeah, we tried this, didn't we? Can I take an order for a boat? Okay. For some reason I thought it was someplace that I had gone in. Just looking around in case I miss somebody in here. It was way back the end of the Limping Rogue. Who is this again? Yeah, what did you say? That the well has magical powers, possibly. See, this looks like an adventure. But no. And this is the landlady. Landis. Stand by, guys. So I'm just continuing to look around because I'm surprised there's no character here to join our party. Maybe in here? Looks like a big empty area. Maybe these are two shops here? Maybe there's another thing here? Everything else looks pretty much accounted for. Merchant. What does that mean? Oh, there's a merchant on the other side? Wait a second. Then I could sell stuff. Is it getting dark now? So not really straight ahead, but this way. Ah. Foodstuffs. We don't need foodstuffs.